Welcome back and welcome to part two of the Pet Cuddlatron demo series. In this part of the demo, we start at this point where we just completed the configuration of the simple email service. In part two of this demo series, we'll be extending on this, we'll be adding Lambda and some configuration to allow our state machine to use the simple email service. So this is the configuration that we'll be creating. We'll be creating a Lambda function, and we'll be configuring the permissions so that this Lambda function can utilize the simple email service to send us notification emails. Now this will mean that we'll need to create a Lambda execution role, which is the thing that gives our Lambda function the permissions it needs to interact with SES, and we'll need to set up the function itself. So let's move across to the console and get started. Now, a link containing the full instructions and architecture diagrams for all stages of the demo lesson are attached to this and all the parts of the demo series. So I do encourage you to check out the full text instructions, because every step that you'll do in all stages of this demo series are contained within these text-based instructions, and it will make it much easier to follow. Now, the first step to performing this part of the configuration is that we'll need to create an IAM role that can be assumed by our Lambda functions. Now, you've already created IAM roles earlier in the course, and so I'm going to go ahead and get you to apply a CloudFormation template to do this on your behalf. Now, there's a one-click deployment link attached to this lesson and in this lesson's instructions. If you just go ahead and open that, it'll take you to the Quick Create Stack screen. The stack name should already be populated with Lambda role. Just scroll down, check the capabilities box, and click Create Stack. Now this will take a few minutes, so go ahead and pause the video and resume it once it's in Create Complete. Now once that is in a Create Complete, if you move back across and go to the IAM console, we should now have a role that can be assumed by our Lambda functions. So click on Roles, just scroll down, and you're looking for one that's got Lambda role in the name. So this is one that's just been created by our CloudFormation template. Let's just open that up. If you look at the trust relationships, you can see that it's assumable by lambda.amazonaws.com. So that means Lambda can assume this role. And if we go to the permissions policy and just expand this, you'll see that the Lambda function has permissions on SES, SNS, and states. And states means that this Lambda function can interact with state machines inside step functions. So this provides all of the permissions that this Lambda function needs to interact with these three services. In addition, we also grant it the ability to log any of its logging and diagnostic information into CloudWatch logs. So that's great. We've got all the permissions that we need inside this execution role. Now that we've configured the role, the next step is to create the Lambda function itself. So click on Services and type Lambda into the Find Services box to move across to the Lambda console. Once we're in the Lambda console, we need to create the Email Reminder Lambda function. So go ahead and click on Create Function. We'll be authoring the function from scratch. The name of the function will be email_reminder_lambda. And then for the runtime, we're going to use Python, but if you refer to the text instructions for this lesson or this lesson's description, it will tell you exactly which version of Python to select in this dropdown. Next, under permissions, expand change default execution role, choose to use an existing role, and then in the existing role dropdown, click and select Lambda role. And once you've done that, go ahead and click on Create function. So this means this Lambda function now has the ability to interact with the three services that it needs as part of our serverless application. Next, just scroll down, right click on Lambda_function and select Open. Now what I want you to do is select all of the skeleton code that's pre-populated and just go ahead and delete it. And then, attached to this lesson and in the instructions for this stage of the demo series, is some Lambda code that you need to copy into your clipboard. And then just go ahead and paste in that code from your clipboard, and you'll spot right away that there is a placeholder that you'll need to replace. All this code does is import some libraries that will be used during its execution. It makes a connection to the SES service using the standard BOTO3 client, and then it sends an email using data that's passed to it by the state machine. So when this Lambda function is invoked by the state machine, it's given this event object, and inside this object will be the destination email address to send to, as well as a brief message. And so here, where we're sending the email using SES, it's just extracting the destination email address to use, as well as the brief message. So all of this information is passed in when the state machine invokes this Lambda function. So before we save this, I want you to replace the placeholder. So I want you to select the text that's replace underscore me in caps, and I want you to replace that with the email address that you want this application to send from. This needs to be one of the two email addresses that you verified in SES in the previous part of this demo series. This will be the email address that the application will send from. So it needs to be one of those addresses that you verified that you control. You can't use my address. It won't function if you use my address. You need to use one of your own. Now, once you've replaced that placeholder, go ahead and click on the deploy button, and then just make sure that the function is reporting as deployed. Now, it will create the Lambda function, and before we finish up this part of the demo series, I'll want you to scroll all the way to the top and copy down the ARN for this Lambda function. So this will be unique to you. It shows the region, your account number, and then the name of the Lambda function that you've created. So if you're following along with this in your own account, in the same region, using the same name, the only difference will be this account number. It will have your account number here, rather than mine, but you do need to make sure that you copy your own ARN for this function, and I'll just want you to note it down somewhere safe and make a note that it's the ARN for the email Lambda function, because we'll need this very shortly. Now, in addition, as you move through all the lessons of this demo series, you might want to just leave the tabs open to these various components. So leave a tab open to the IAM console, leave a tab open to this specific Lambda function, and for each major component of each part of this demo series, just go ahead and leave the tab open to that component. What that will allow you to do is, rather than having to locate all of these components in the future parts of this demo series where you need them, you can just return to the tab. At this point, though, that's all of the practical tasks that we need to complete in this part of the demo series. So now at this point, you've implemented this architecture. You've created the email reminder Lambda function, you've given it the permissions it requires to interact with the SES service, and you've edited the placeholder so that it will send email from the address that you verified inside the SES service. So at this point, this architecture is implemented, and we're good to move on to part three of this demo series, which is where we'll implement the state machine itself. But at this point, that's all you need to do in this part of the demo series. So go ahead, complete the video, and when you're ready, I look forward to you joining me in the next part of this series.